So anyway, that's the only indication I would say that if you have, but otherwise the keratometry does not make a difference at all when you're using a femto flap. Okay, so I'll show you smile, and I'll show you the bad parts of smile as to how horrible a surgeon I am or maybe somebody else. So anyway, so the challenging with smiles are rare, manageable, and usually there is not much of a problem in solving these things. So I think all of you must have seen a video of smile, so I'm not showing you. I'm showing you some things which people don't show, but actually it's a collection of over 10,000 eyes, and I thank Gitansha Eye Foundation for their help also in collecting these. So mind you, this is again, we don't, so this was in Eye Foundation. The flap cilia was in center of sight. So you can see that cilias everywhere misbehave. So you need to take care of the cilias, and this obviously when you're draping the cilia coat. So you can see again, this is an uncut area. So mind you, friends, if there is a debris which is as thick as that, please, please just remove that. You need to redock and do that. So you can see the difficulty in the dissections that is there. Now let me just talk about suction loss. Suction loss does happen to the extent of about 1% in cases of smile. And there are reasons to that. The first thing is that it does not applanate to make it totally flat. You still maintain the convexity of the cornea, and it is not a hard dock. Okay? And it is a 360-degree suction. The patient actually keeps on seeing the blinking green light throughout the procedure, except till the OBL comes and the OBL obviates this thing. So that is the main problem. And because it takes about 23 seconds for the entire procedure to go as regards a flap, it would be about half that time. But one important thing about smile is that irrespective of the dioptic correction that you are correcting, the time taken would remain the same. Okay, so if I am doing an eczema or LASIK for minus 1 and I am doing something for minus 10, the time taken would be 10 times more. In this particular case, it will still be the same. Why? Because you are just increasing the depth at which you are moving the two planes. That's about it. So now let's just see that. So this is what the machine does. So if you have just started the procedure, so the first step in a smile is the lower part of the lenticule. Okay, so if you have less than 10% cut, then the machine will automatically restart. So this small little rim that has been created, it does not make any difference. If you have more than 10% of the first cut, but before the side cut has been completed, for that, you will have to convert it into a femto flap. Okay, so that is the important thing that you have. And during the lenticule side cut, you can repeat the lenticule. During the cap cut, you could repeat the cap cut. And during the cap side cut, you could do this. So let me just show you a couple of videos in quick succession. So you can see this suction lost. Okay? Converted into a flap. Lifted as a flap, no problems. Okay? So if you are more than 10% of the first cut, but before you have completed the side cut of this thing, then you make it into a femto flap and you can go ahead and do it. Now, this is suction loss during anterior lenticule cut. So in this particular case, you can see this is, if you can you just watch this? I'll just show you again. This is a large cylinder. Just look at the cut that is coming. Can you see this? The shape of it, it wasn't purely round. So this is a cylindrical power which is there. So you can see this first cut, side cut. Watch this. Can you see this? Ideally, you should stop here. Okay, because you know there's no way you are going to complete it and you lose suction. So that's fine. So what do you do here is you redock. Can you see that? You use the same cone. The machine automatically goes to step 3. And you start right from where it was, it will reach the same plane. The only thing that you can see here is that between this and this, there is a gap. So the docking is not exactly central as to where it should have been. But really, it does not cause any problem. You can see there's the OBL is slightly more, but as soon as you enter, you see the OBL getting released and the white area getting reduced. So you can see, I'll just go in here and do this. This is the separation. And you can see the separation again, the lower lenticule, and you can remove this lenticule that is there. And sorry, I just missed forward. So anyway, there's no problem. The second thing is dissection difficulties. So when you have dissection difficulties, ideally, for those who do SMILE, the first plane should be where that you enter? It should be above the lenticule or below the lenticule? Sorry? Above the lenticule, right. Because otherwise, if you are below the lenticule will stick to the undersurface, and you can see that we are working on this, and I'm not able to find the second plane. Okay, so you can see, now you can see I've been able to delineate the plane. So I have to do like a reverse capsulorhexis. Can you make this out? Okay, and now I am going in. Now this is the upper plane. So actually, if there is a dissection difficulty, you have to identify the second plane and you have to do a reverse dissection that is there, and we'll be able to get it out. Okay. Okay, you can see this is the flap that has come out. This is something that rarely happens if your energy settings are not really good. You can see here it is a mess. You have actually broken the lenticule. It is something which in the, I don't remember, but 6,000-7,000 eyes that we have done, I have rarely had this kind of complications. And can you see when you hydrate it, this is a lenticule that is sticking. You can remove it. Later on also you can do an OCT and see as to what it is. This is another thing that happens. This is a side cut extension. If you actually lift, can you see this? This forceps is being lifted up, while it should be not lifted up, and you can see you get a side cut extension. And one final video, there is a lot of this thing as to how you do an enhancement in a SMILE. Either you can do a surface ablation, or you have what is called as a circle scan. So now you can see this, you have to ideally go into the same depth. You can see we are, what we are doing is that the cap is being converted into a flap. So you can see this is an extension. And this again goes, and it's like a donut, and the cap, you can see, has been converted into a flap. So this is obviously a couple of months after the procedure has been done, and you can see from where the original lenticule had been taken out, you can use an excimer laser now and do an enhancement procedure. Okay, is that clear? So this I'll leave. There is an epithelial growth ingrowth because something has been put in. And that's a problem. So you could either do a circle, lift it up and remove, or you can go in with the, into the same opening and do that. So that is the video assisted things that I wanted to show you on SMILE. Thank you very much for your kind.